In our lifetimes, many of us have witnessed the resurgence of the sailing canoe tradition, beginning with Hokulea. This voyage of rediscovery is a powerful example of where we need to go as a community and how our traditional values can help to guide us. Since the early days of Hokulea, a number of canoes have been launched and form a network of living classrooms for young people around our islands. Through the teaching of traditional Hawaiian values and practical lessons in life, the experiences on these canoes are changing our youth and play a vital role in raising up young leaders in our community.
I had the great fortune of sailing aboard one of our double-hulled sailing canoes named Makali'i. She's an offspring of Hokulea. I think the most central lesson that has really stuck with me since then to now is he moku he va'a, he va'a he moku. The canoe is an island, as an island is a canoe. And just that statement alone poses this really important question that I ask myself pretty much every day. And that question is, what would a collective culture look like? How can we all get along on this island of Oahu, this pai aina of Hawaii, so that we can nurture one another, so we can care for one another, so we can sustain, not only survive, but how can we thrive again?
What is our collective culture? And how do we make that work for this and future generations? One of our greatest strengths is found in the values and diversity of our multicultural heritage.
There are many places in the world where people have gathered representing all nations, all faces, all colors. Hawaii is one of those places where not only have we welcomed them, if we've all arrived, but we've actually married one another. We've shared foods, we've shared cultures, we've shared religions and spirituality. We've become much more than the sum of our parts.
We have become a wonderfully, beautifully multicultural society. We are so intertwined beautifully, our families and our communities, that it really truly will take the combination of us all, the combining of us all, to move these islands forward in a way that is healthy and vibrant and full of aloha and makes us glad that we live here and makes us dream and hope that our children will choose to stay here and bring up their families in such a wonderful, wonderful home.
Glenn Furuya is a leadership expert that's been studying and teaching about Hawaii's unique culture for years. From the schoolroom to the boardroom, he shares that our special blend of culture holds the key to our future.
Hawaii is a really special place. It's a place where three cultures come together and create a blended kind of essence here. You have the humility of Eastern cultures, the drive of American Western culture, and the warmth and hospitality and inclusiveness of Hawaiian and Polynesian cultures. Blend the three together, a special place evolves, a special people evolves, which makes us unique and different from anything else that I see out there in the world. What has to happen, I believe, is we must embark on a renaissance to reawaken the people and reawaken the fire to make this place special and to preserve the specialness of Hawaii.
Passing down our values and cultural traditions is something our ancestors did. This is vital if we are to hold on to what we care about and work towards this positive collective culture. Today, a significant effort is being made throughout our islands to pass on these values and traditions to our youth, and it's making a huge difference. Partners in Development is an organization that is making significant strides in teaching youth through traditional Hawaiian values. From Tutu and Me Traveling Preschool, to preschool for homeless children on the beach, to working with underprivileged youth, they are doing a tremendous job of helping our young people see a brighter future.
When we begin to talk about the values of aloha, the value of lokahi, the value of mālama, of pōkela, these are things that all of a sudden changes the paradigm for them. And we see kids come alive as they're connected to the values of their forefathers.
In North Kohala on the Big Island, a program named Kahana no Iau is focused on the traditional practices of mentoring.
Mentoring is not something that is new. The word becoming more and more popular, but it was one way of preserving our culture and our arts.
Kahana no Iao has 9 mentoring programs, but their primary focus is saddle making and the Paniolo life that goes along with it. The other programs range from native plant propagation, lo'i kalu in the mountains, to culinary arts.
Learning to do, doing to learn, earning to live, and living to serve. We take what their interest area is and we teach them a skill set, and we connect that skill set to our Hawaiian values. At the same time, we also teach them how to make that into a business. So we teach them how to write a business plan. And we recently have incorporated science projects in their programs. We need to prepare our young ladies and young men for the future. We need to preserve our culture. We need to preserve our aloha spirit.
For Kahana no Iao, the focus is to pass down knowledge generation to generation.
For a culture to keep itself sustainable, they need to do this for 7 generations. How do we take that and multiply it so that our people beyond our great-great-great-grandchildren will still be here in Hawaii and happy and have that aloha spirit? That's sustainability.
Isaac Sproat is a young man who's been in the program for almost 2 years. He came out of the foster care program to live with his grandmother and grandfather, well-known falsetto singer Kindi Sproat.
I grew up having a hard life, having to move from house to house, and just being an independent person from a young age.
Isaac's heart, when he first came and stayed with us, Kindi's health issues were pretty bad. And we feel very fortunate having Isaac here in the home.
I don't know, it just touches me when I see him come home. Everything that he sees, he takes it in. He listens and he takes in. He's a sponge.
You can't sit back and not do nothing and get what you want. Like Grandpa has always told me, work hard to get what you want, for in the end you'll get what you want because you worked hard.
Since coming to Kohala and joining Kahana no Iao, Isaac has blossomed and is now the student body president of Kohala High School.
Because I joined this program, I learned a lot of patience. I also learned a lot of leadership skills. I think it's very important to be around adults who has the knowledge and wisdom to teach us young kids today about the value of culture. And just to be around that is such a special feeling for us, because our generation nowadays, we have to pick it up and we have to gain that knowledge to pass it on to our next generation.
Passing down knowledge to the next generation is one of the most important parts of perpetuating the values, hopes, and dreams of our ancestors who live their lives in a way that preserve the values and culture that we have today. A reminder of just how important this is comes from the reality that Kindi Sproat passed away just a month after doing this interview. We have to ask ourselves, who in our lives should we be spending time with? Who should we be learning from? And who should we be passing the knowledge down to? Our kupuna should be a priority for all of us, as they are the greatest source of wisdom and our connection to our heritage and values. We need to take the time to know them, take care of them, and honor them.
As we move into the future, it's vital for us to recognize and foster this culture of respect and learning between all generations. Na Leo Pilimehana shares with us a song that speaks about this very important responsibility.
This song was written by 2 kupuna who were good friends of my mother and my tutu. The words are written by Auntie Violet Hughes, and Auntie Violet Hughes didn't drive, so she caught the bus everywhere she went, and she wrote the words to this song on the back of an envelope one day while she was waiting at the bus stop. And she kept that envelope in her purse for several months until one day she showed it to Auntie Miley Vargo. And Auntie Miley was inspired to write the music to it. And that very day that she put the music to the words, the Kupuna got together, learned their parts, and sang it as a makana for the opening of Ho'olako, Year of the Hawaiian, in 1987. The song talks about how Kupuna and Makua and the Keiki and all the people of this nation of Hawaii need to come together as one so that the Hawaiian people may thrive. Iola kako na Hawaii. The message of the song is important for all people who live in Hawaii. The culture, the music, the dance, everything that's special about Hawaii is right here, and that we need to preserve it. And the way that we thrive is that the elders and the parents and the children all come together as one, and that there's a unity and there's a family spirit. I want our people to know that there's hope and there's a future, and if we all come together, that we can do great things.
I would love to see Hawaii's future become a future where everyone, instead of saying, I cannot, say, I can and I will. I want people to know that dreams are reachable, that dreams are right in front of you, and that for those of us who may not be able to see that far down the road, don't worry about it. As long as you vision it and you think it and you always stay positive, things can happen to everyone. Oh my, na la hui, hey, oh my.